Hi, welcome to my car, welcome to my YouTube channel today. Welcome also in KyeBriq product introduction part 2. You could see all the basic stuff in my video from yesterday. You can find the link in the text below video. Today I want to show you some advanced properties of this KyeBriq. So at first it is remote control. Remote control, which is working on the Bluetooth, so you can run it. And now you can see that there is possible also power screen or power on screen. You can run with this remote control to basic screen, and you can list in your menu, for example, here or here. Yes, you can volume control in this, you can mute, and you can also give this mouse a link, and you can some give position and run what do you want. So now we will back to a main menu, for example, with this remote control, and now I power off this mouse. Fine. So, and you will see what is new on this box. So, at the first, I add some application from Google Play on my basic this menu, so you can see that there is some new, as for example Android Info, for example Messenger, Gmail, My, and also floating apps for auto. We will see what is interesting on this application in this car. So now we look at Android Info, so you can see the system, you can see the processor. It is ARMy 64 processor. Memories, there is inside also my external card, SD card, and what is very important is temperature of this box. You can see that this temperature is between 40 and 50 degrees all processor temperature, so it is very good. So fine, we will go back to our basic screen. Yes, and today I want to show you how it's possible to run Wi-Fi Android Auto or change it to Wi-Fi CarPlay. So here is application Speed Play. So when I run it, so it is now waiting to connection, and on your device you must have a little moment Wi-Fi connection for Android AP. This is AP hotspot of this brick, KyeBriq, and in Bluetooth you must connect to KyeBriq. And now about 5-10 seconds will be connecting this Wi-Fi to this Android Auto. So you will see that there is now running a Wi-Fi Android Auto, and I want to see you still one possibility. It's this floating apps for auto. This is special floating application which is floating upper on this Wi-Fi Android Auto, and you can run some other things from this windows. For example, you can run video, or you can run Facebook and other application from this floating apps. So you can see now that there is floating window which is running upper on Google Maps or other applications from Android Auto. So you can run independent in this two window. You can this window made bigger or smaller. You can run it on all screen and in full screen, of course. So now I will close it in bubble. So as yes, I have two video in this time, and now I can show you how it is possible to change Wi-Fi Android Auto to Wi-Fi CarPlay. So what we must do? So at first we will shut down Bluetooth and shut down Wi-Fi on this and on my iPhone. We must run Bluetooth and run Wi-Fi. So in Wi-Fi we connect to this hotspot. Yes, it's good. And in Bluetooth we connect to KyeBriq. So, and you can see that is iPhone running. So, and this is CarPlay. So you will see that it is very quickly. So about 20 seconds we change Wi-Fi Android Auto to Wi-Fi CarPlay. And what is interesting, in this Wi-Fi iOS system is also possible run this Windows from floating subsoar auto. So we can run, for example, here video from, this is video from my car play from my iPhone, and in this time, for example, you can run also video from Windows here. So it is independent. You can use, of course, any address application from floating subsoar auto, and the same any address application from CarPlay. So what so about image viewer? So you can see some of my photos in independent windows, and here we can run with, for example, message or other application, because this my phone is KyeBriq, so there is also other application which is not standard in the CarPlay. But this Wi-Fi connection is for all also non-KyeBriq devices. So thank you for your interest, and I will in next video. Fine, bye.